But that affirmation is declared at this place on this date is verification. That you're verifying that all those affirmations which I made above, I hereby declare to be true as per my own knowledge. And I swear by the same. So these are minute differences, but very important. Now coming to a situation that we have gone up to 73, 74. And if you see, as I told you, 79 to 90 is the presumptions. I also want to inform you that there are two situations which has created a lot of confusion in the courts. That when you produce a document, the court tends to exhibit it. Now, exhibiting a document is actually putting a mark so that the court knows that this document is part of the record. Now, most of the lawyers who are uncomfortable about the exhibiting of a document want to object it. That such and such document must not be exhibited or must not be given exhibit number. So the question arose, what should the court do to in the face of this objection? Should the court decide your objection immediately? Or should the court defer to decide that objection at a later stage? So the orthodox view, the original view, since 1931 Lahore, in the judgment of Baldev Sahai, the orthodox view is that the document which is produced as evidence must be decided by the court as admissible, only then it should be exhibited. The court should not put exhibit mark without deciding the objection raised by the other side. This is the traditional orthodox view since Baldev Sahai's judgment of 1931 Lahore. Now this orthodox view that the objection must be immediately decided then and there has been followed in all the courts across India, because that was the view holding field. This was followed in 1961, it was followed in the judgment 1971 RVE Venkat Chalam's judgment, it was followed in Saith Karim Chand's judgment 1971 Supreme Court, and even Bombay High Court till 2003 and 4 in the judgment of Durga Shankar versus Durga Shankar Trivedi, judgment of 2003 Bombay, and 2004 also decided that once an objection is raised by the opposite party about the exhibiting of the document, the court must decide that objection immediately and then move forward. But then came a landmark judgment in 2001 by the Supreme Court. You must have heard about that judgment. It's written Shantilal Panchal versus State of Gujarat, 2001 Supreme Court. Bipin Shantilal Panchal's judgment, for the first time, the Supreme Court under the bench presided by Justice K.T. Thomas held that the objection raised about the admissibility of a document can be deferred by the court till the final stage and may be dealt with while passing the final judgment. The court should not stop the trial and delay the trial by deciding these objections, otherwise the trial will never be over. Every now and then new objection would keep coming. So to expedite the trial, the Supreme Court and Bipin Panchal's judgment held that these objections can be taken onto record. The document must be exhibited tentatively. You have to put an exhibit mark tentatively, subject to the objection being considered at the final stage of the judgment. Now, Bipin Panchal's judgment in 2003 was followed by the Supreme Court in Navjot Sandhu's judgment. Navjot Sandhu, State versus Navjot Sandhu, 2003 Supreme Court, followed Bipin Panchal's judgment. And thereafter, during the period of Durga Shankar, when Bombay High Court was deciding that the objection should be dealt with immediately, at the same time, different benches of Bombay High Court had different views. So Durga Shankar's judgment by Justice Chandrachud said, decide immediately. Whereas another judgment, 2004 Bombay High Court by Justice Wajibdar, I am just forgetting the name, it was versus ONGC, I'll recollect it. It is 2004 Justice Wajibdar's judgment, who said, following Bipin Panchal's line of the Supreme Court, that the objection can be taken care of at the time of the final judgment. So Bombay High Court at the same time, contemporary time, different benches held different things. And there was a lot of confusion. 2004 also, ONGC, that was Baman Irani versus ONGC, 2004 Bombay. Baman Irani versus ONGC 2004 Bombay held that Justice Wajibdar's judgment, which said that the objection can be tentatively marked exhibit and can be taken care at the final stage. And this was followed in 2005 Bombay ONGC versus FPU Tahar. It was a ship's name. So these judgments created a lot of confusion, because our own High Court have two divergent views by two different benches. So this was referred finally to a full bench of the Bombay High Court. And three judges bench under the leadership of the Chief Justice of Bombay High Court was formed in Hemendra Rasiklal Ghia. Hemendra Rasiklal Ghia, that judgment of 2008 Bombay, full bench. It's a very, very exhaustive judgment dealing with almost all the history of exhibiting and proving and admissibility of the documents. Very exhaustively, very informative. I recommend that you must go through this judgment. 2008 Bombay full bench, judgment of Hemendra Rasiklal Ghia. It's a wonderful judgment, which finally, quoting Supreme Court in RVE Venkat Chalam's, stated that there are two kinds of a situation. When the objections are raised by lawyers about any document, they categorize even the objections into two categories. First, they said that there is normally an objection about the admissibility of a document. The lawyers raised that this document is not admissible as an evidence, so this should not be given exhibit number. Like, for example, in a recent case, most of you must have dealt with negotiable instrument 138 cases. In a check bouncing case, when you list the exhibits, one of an important exhibit is a bank memo. Have you ever noticed that a bank memo can be subjected to objection? Most of the lawyers see, theek hai, check original hai, bank ka original document hai, kaun admits it? Admit and reject ke stage par, no one. It's an important thing which you must pay attention to. Because a bank memo, if does not have a seal of the bank, then it must be objected. It is not admissible. Now when you object, normally the other side says computer generated hai sahab. Ye bada standard answer hai. Anubhav se bata raha. But if you pay attention, Section 146 of the Negotiable Instruments Act does not talk about the computer generated thing. So your computer generated story may be in a different scenario. Under IT Act, that secured document computer generated is recognized, but not under Negotiable Instruments Act. 146 categorically says that if you want to prove a document, the document must be proved as authentic by the bank. So, suppose if there is no seal, can that document is not admissible? Yes, it may be, because if it has had a watermark. You know what is watermark? If you see High Court's judgment, original High Court judgment, it is on a paper which has High Court's logo behind. That is called watermark. So either the slip should have, bank memo should have that watermark. Otherwise, on a piece of paper, that printout you can also take out in office, no? What is the distinction? So if that document does not have any authenticity of the bank, you must object it. Now the question is, when will the court take your objection? When will the court decide? Just now or at the final stage? So that is where this Hemendra Ghia's judgment, taking RVE, Venkat Chalam's Supreme Court judgment, taking cue from there, stated that there are two types of objections. One is about the admissibility of the document, which can be decided at the final stage. Now remember, if your objection is in respect of the admissibility of a document, then this judgment says that the court can decide that objection at the final stage, final judgment stage. This means Bipin Panchal's theory is followed. 2001, 2008, Bombay High Court full bench confirming that. We're only making a distinction. The second category is of objections are when the document is admissible, but the mode of proof is not. See, you are not raising an objection about the admissibility of a document. You are saying, yes, yes, this is an admissible document, but the method of proving is wrong. Hence, my objection should be taken on record. And Hemendra Ghia's judgment, the Bombay High Court and the full bench said that if the objection is in respect of the mode of proving, then the court must decide it then and there before moving ahead. Then the court cannot procrastinate till final stage. Mode of proving has to be decided immediately. Ye kuch confuse kar raha hai kya aapko? Mode of proving? Admissibility is a different thing, mode of proving is a different thing. Aisi kaun si situation hogi jahan aap document ke production ko to admissible manenge?